Nah. I heard we're not doing all shit by myself.
One of the things we pride ourselves on here is
work together.
We work as a team.
At least on video, huh?
Yeah, outside of the video is a different story.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. There's a separator plate going in. Up over the guide studs. Looking good.
That one's a little tight. I'm going to open this hole up just a hair.
Okay, he's going to probably use a rat tail file or some such thing to open up that access hole just a little bit because it is a little bit tight. Take off a little polish from the inside diameter of that hole. It's nice to see how dry those oil pan gaskets and seals are holding. Okay, for anybody who's wondering why Nick took so long to clean off all the metal filings of this plate once he hogged that hole out a bit, I don't think it was because he was worried about metal pieces getting inside the seals, the rear main seal or the front seal, but more that putting that plate up, if there's any metal debris dropping down, it could get in his eyes. That would be bad news. I'm glad he cleaned it up. I didn't have to say anything, which tells me he's done it before. Okay, separator plate looks good. I'm going to take offline until the tranny is ready to be bolted up. The flex plate. There is the offsetting weight. I don't know how big it was on the other flex plate. I'm hoping it's about the same size, volume-wise at least, because there are two different counterweights to this. Okay, good deal. Thank you. And yep, here is the old flex plate, and it looks like they're about the same size. The size difference between the two different weights is significant. Here, these sizes, length and width might be a little bit different, but the thickness of the metal will also add or reduce the total mass or weight of the offsetting weight. Those look pretty close, so I say we've done good. Not getting on video what Nick asked Alex to do, but the torque converter is coming out of the box. and then about a quart of tranny fluid is going to be poured into the torque converter so that there is some fluid in there. At the time we initially start the engine up, that'll give it a chance to go ahead and get things in motion so that nothing starts up dry. The new flux plate diameter is a little bit larger than the old flux plate, and that's one of the reasons for the torque converter. That and the stall speed of this one, I think, is 2800 RPM, maybe 3200, but it's a little bit higher than the stock torque converter would have been. It's been threaded in loosely. There's only one way for those things to go on with the bolt pattern, at least without forcing something. So it's snugged up there. Nothing to it. That looks like it's right, just a little bit tough for you.
Yeah, just being a little.
Just being ornery.
Yep.
The other bolts patterns are just close enough to not be right. But this one looks like it's more right than the rest of them. Hopefully we won't have to hog anything out. We'll see. Just leave a bolt out, the other five will hold it. He's snugging down these bolts using a ratchet, not an impact. He wants to make sure that when the flex plate goes on and stays straight, doesn't get buckled or warped or anything else because of too tight a fitting tolerance, which does happen at times with these. Meantime, Alex wants to go fetch the torque wrench instead of for 85 pound feet. So that once these things are snugged up, they can go ahead and tighten them down. That cross star pattern, and we'll be ready to snug it all up.
Okay.
Eighty-five pound feet. Now notice that Nick is going in a cross pattern. He's not going side by side bolts. He went across the other side. That is typical star pattern type of tightening with bolts around a round item like this, like our back of a crankshaft or even wheels when they're taken off to change a spare tire. Always tighten it in a star pattern. It's often as if Alex will hold that flex plate in place with his tooth holder. Think worked all his teeth, he could have been a dentist. This is more fun. Cars don't feel pain.
No, but the owners do.
Yeah, maybe. I have a high threshold. And since Nick has been marking these bolts with a little black marker, we can see which ones have been tightened and which ones haven't. And they all have been tightened. I can't tell. The bottom one got done?
Yep.
Okay. Can't tell from here. I'm glad you marked them. Okay, so flex plate is all tightened on to the back of the crankshaft. Now my guess is we're going to slide the torque converter in place in the transmission. Secure the torque converter so it doesn't slide out as it's being lifted up. And then we're going to bolt it up, mate it up, and bolt it up to the bell housing.
Yeah, this one's going to be a little more weight.
Yeah, that end is no longer protruding, so it's definitely in place. It took a couple of turns and monkeying around, but it finally went in. Okay. Now the trick is not just getting the tranny up, but getting the tranny up with the bell housing angled slightly so the torque converter doesn't slide out of position after all that effort Alex made getting it in place. And here we go. What balls they have. Look at that. Up we go.
It should, because if this bell housing is meant to bolt up to the block,
the starter a little bit further out.
It's because of the bigger flex plate. So we may have to, once we get it up there, we may have to twist it up and then in. Go ahead and pump it up.
Look, he's doing all the hard work and pumping it this time. That's why we have Alex over here. Well, the bad news is the battery is getting low on the cell phone. The good news is it means pretty soon I can't record this anymore. You guys start having some fun instead of being on your best behavior just because you have an audience.
How are you doing for room over there?
Not a lot.
Because I do have a tab on this side that's going to be...
I think let's kind of maybe can you rotate this to twist that up to get your tab up a little bit? Once your tabs are up and over, we gotta slide it that way because the starter gear is quite large.
There's darn headers.
If we keep it angled like this, it's clear.
Seems to be clearing.
Wow!
Okay, slow down a little bit because I gotta just keep an eye on this e-brake cable. I don't know if
we
can't clear it yet.
Straighten it, angle it straightened again, and then rotate this to straighten out.
Can we come forward at all?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So theoretically, this is a quarter inch longer than the C4. So I should be able to stretch this. Just like that.
Look at that. Okay. Excellent.
I'm good to keep going.
So far, we've been very lucky.
Oh,
I haven't heard Alex scream. That means the torque converter hasn't slipped out yet.
Nope.
Still in place.
You might be able to keep squeezing it through. Okay, so the shift linkage is a little tight with long tubes, but it is manageable to squeeze it up through. Clearance here, And keep an eye on your dowel pins. I do. Okay, so
I can see you over here.
Yep.
Well, we've got some good clearance of the transmission tunnel still, better than I expected. Hoping we'd have plenty of clearance, and we do, which would be good once we start playing around with the linkage for shifting. the throttle valve. Look at that. Lots of room. But like Nick said, a little bit tight for the shifting linkage right now, but I think once we're bolted up, we're going to be fine.
Towards the
yep.
A little high for my dial pin, I think. I don't know what you are, how you are for yours. My whole corner is a little high.
Mine's not too bad.
Okay, Al comes down right behind you, not to be a pain in the ass. I'm just trying to get the shot of the torque converter bolts when they come through the flex plate.
Do you want me to rotate my side down a little bit?
Well, I might go up a little bit like this.
Yeah, because my side's going to have to come down. It's almost like we're going to have to rotate counterclockwise.
Okay, because I'm about to be on my dowel. About to be on my dowel right now.
You're on the dowel?
Almost.
Okay, I think I'm lined up with mine.
I'm gonna find something I can hang this on.
This is always the most fun part. Lining up the bell housing bolts and then getting the torque converter lined up and then sliding it all together.
Okay. One of these? Is that hurting you?
Nope. Okay, so I'm on my dowel pin. So if you need to rotate, as long as I keep pressure on my dowel pin, I should be able to rotate if needed. How's our torque converter stud? Is it?
It's not spun in place that I can tell yet. There we go. Am I in your way?
No, you're good.
Okay.
So I'm lined up with a dowel pin. I just got to get pushed in.
Okay, torque converter is a little bit off, but I think once you pull forward, it'll slide in.
Maybe if we tip it back up a little bit.
Okay, so my side needs to come down.
Okay, that's perfect over here for the torque converter bolt. Okay, I have been.
I'm on my dowel pin. You still on yours?
We shove in, it'll go on.
Yeah, go up just a little. Okay, it all popped away. Hope I'm not interfering with you guys thinking. Okay, almost perfect, just straight up now for the torque converter bolt.
My dowel is not on all the way.
There!
Nope, I popped out.
Yours popped out?
Yep. Now I'm in. Yours pop out?
Try going, give the tranny back just a little bit of a pump, because I think we're pinching a little.
Because I'm about to be on. Well, I'm started on. I don't know if you want to thread a bolt in a little bit and kind of walk it back and forth.
Okay. I see we get bolts pulled in the rest of the way. So I got the shot that I wanted, the torque converter mounting bolt coming through the one hole of the flex plate. So I'm going to go offline, get out of these guys' way. Alex was trying to get the bell housing mounting bolts in place. He took note that the mounting flange on the AOD is a little thicker than the mounting flange on the C4. So he scampered off to look for some new bolts that are maybe a quarter inch longer than the original mounting bolts. As long as they're grade 8 bolts, we're good to go. But keep that in mind as you do your AOD swap. Your bell housing original bolts might be a little bit short. If you had a C4 transmission, if you had a C6, my guess is those bolts are the same length, because the flange would be a little bit thicker on that bell housing on a C6 compared to a C4. Anyway, Alex got some bolts that are a little bit longer and quite a bit longer than the original bolts. But if you take a look in the head, you see that there's half grade markers. So these aren't soft bolts. They aren't super, super hard. But I think there's a grade 5, and that will be just fine for this application because there's not that much big stress on these. The bolts he's putting in are about a quarter inch longer than the original bolts. That should make up for the difference in thickness of the flange. And where the bolts come out from bolt holes, there's nothing obtrusive, nothing in the way. So if they're a little bit too long, that's okay. They aren't going to bottom out anywhere.
The shorter one's only 3 threads sticking out.
Give me a longer one.
Here's a longer one here if you need it.
Thank you.
Okay, so the little bit longer bolts weren't quite enough. So the longer bolts, boy, we glad Alex decided to get 2 different lengths. Only one trip to make. One thing that I had noticed off camera was at the driver rear of the pan, there is a drain bolt in the pan. That is not a stock feature of this AOD. This pan had that drain bolt put in, probably from the folks at Monster Transmission. It's a nice touch. It makes it so much easier and cleaner to drain these things and drop the pan.
How much did you tighten it down?
I snugged it. Because I just wanted to make sure it was going to pull it in.
Is there a gap or not?
No. Well, I've got them fully mated and then we'll put it in.
Is the dark rubber going through?
Right on schedule. The two bolts out of that tranny mount, and I don't know.
Okay, at this point, Alex is putting in the transmission mount that then bolts the cross member, and the cross member is an aftermarket unit made specifically for Mustangs with an AOD being installed. Up goes a cross member. We'll see if it fits with the tranny mount where it's bolted. It has a little bit of slot length front and rear. That's some bolt holes.
All right, you can get right to those holes.
Is your hole lined up at all? Or
gotta go slide your way.
Okay, so tranny.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Okay, so.
Might be able to get a bolt in right there.
On yours?
Yeah, maybe. Does it matter front to back?
Back to front.
first bolt.
Do you want me to loosen up that mount? Because you can get right to it.
Yeah.
Sounded happy.
Now the problem is we gotta get the...
Do you want me to try and sneak my hand into this bolt?
Yeah, but I'm gonna have to push the tail shaft over this way to line up the...
There's two bolts, there's two holes. Which hole is it, the upper one?
Well, the factory one went in the lower. Are you in the upper?
There's only one on this side. I only saw one on this side. And I'm in the lower on this one.
Okay, so in order to be in the lower...
I think there's a lower. I don't know if there's two on this one. There's only one on this side.
Okay, and it is the lower corner, right?
Yeah, right in the corner.
Okay, cross member bolts are in place. Take a look at the offset where the cross member goes to the rear, about 2.5 inches from where it used to be originally. And there's a difference with this aftermarket unit made from AOD. So now it's all lined up and bolts are in place. Alex is going to snug down those tranny mount bolts in the center. And then we'll put nuts on the back of the cross member bolts and call that piece of it done.
That on the back of the bolt, yeah.
Okay, the rest is easy stuff, so I'm coming offline. Okay, we're looked at the drive shaft. The original C4 goes into the spline perfectly. And as far as length, we are so close to where we need to be that we may not have to adjust anything in the length of the drive shaft or the balancing. Now, if this were a C6, we would have had to do some work with it, from what my friend Chris found out. But yeah, this looks like we'll be able to just put it up there, no new yoke, nothing. Now, just so you are aware, those U-joints were replaced about a year and a half ago, so the U-joints ought to be in good shape. The one thing that Nick noticed is that the collector on the headers is very, very close to the oil pan on the AOD transmission. There is a little bit of clearance. We're probably going to be fine, but if we hear any rattling going down the road, I guess I can start shaving away some of the collector. And I have to cut weld splice as required, but boy, he's right, that is really close. Now, with a standard exhaust without headers, that ought not be an issue, but those collectors, they come out to a pretty good sized tube there. So that's where the problem is, or potential problem. Good catch. The other thing you notice, it looks like the cooling line tubes are gonna be a good length to be able to cut, weld, and splice as required to get them to fit. We have some good lengths. We got that, the speedo cable, little bit of linkage stuff, and then I guess we'll do the rest tomorrow once I get the rest of the parts in. Okay, at this point, Alex is putting in the transmission mount that then bolts to the cross member. And the cross member is an aftermarket unit made specifically for Mustangs with an AOD being installed. And up goes the cross member. We'll see if it fits with the tranny mount where it's bolted. It has a little bit of slot length, front and rear. Bolt holes.
Oh, you can get right to those holes.
Is that your hole lined up at all?
Gotta go slide your way.
Okay, so tranny.
Yeah, just a little bit.
Okay, so
might be able to get a bolt in right there.
On yours?
Yeah, maybe. Doesn't matter, front to back.
Back to front.
Bolt.
You want me to loosen up that mount because you can get right to it?
Yeah.
Sounded happy.
Now the problem is we gotta get the...
Do you want me to try and sneak my hand into the bolt?
Yeah, but I'm gonna have to push the tail shaft over this way to line up the...
There's two bolts. There's two holes. Which hole is it? The upper one?
Well, the factory one went in the lower. Are you in the upper?
There's only one on this side. I only saw one on this side. I'm in the lower on this one.
Okay, so in order to be in the lower...
I think there's a low... I don't know if there's two on this one. There's only one on this side.
Okay, and it is the lower corner, right?
Yeah, right in the corner.
Okay, cross member bolts are in place. Take a look at the offset where the cross member goes to the rear, about 2.5 inches from where it used to be originally. And there's a difference with this aftermarket unit made from AOD. So now it's all lined up and bolts are in place. Alex is going to snug down those tranny mount bolts in the center. And then we'll put nuts on the back of the cross member bolts and call that piece of it done.
Just put that on the back of the bolt, yeah.
Okay, the rest is easy stuff, so I'm coming offline. Okay, we're looked at the drive shaft. The original C4 goes into the spline perfectly. And as far as length, we are so close to where we need it to be that we may not have to adjust anything in the length of the drive shaft or the balancing. Now, if this were a C6, we would have had to do some work with it. from what my friend Chris found out, but yeah, this looks like we'll be able to just put it up there, no new yoke, nothing. Now, just so you are aware, those U-joints were replaced about a year and a half ago, so the U-joints ought to be in good shape. The one thing that Nick noticed is that the collector on the headers is very, very close to the oil pan on the AOD transmission. There is a little bit of clearance. We're probably going to be fine, but if we hear any rattling going down the road, I guess I can start shaving away some of the collector. And if I have to cut weld splice as required, but boy, he's right, that is really close. Now, with a standard exhaust without headers, that ought not be an issue, but those collectors, they come out to a pretty good sized tube there. So that's where the problem is, or potential problem. Good catch. The other thing you notice, it looks like the cooling line tubes are gonna be a good length to be able to cut, weld, and splice as required to get them to fit. We have some good lengths. We got that, the speedo cable, a little bit of linkage stuff, and then I guess we'll do the rest tomorrow once I get the rest of the parts in.